Good morning students. In the last lecture we discussed about the perpendicular axis theorem. In this lecture we are going to derive a relation of angular momentum in terms of moment of inertia. For that we consider a rigid body of any shape. We know that the rigid body is made up of large number of particles. Consider the body is made up of large number of particles having masses m1, m2, m3 up to mn, and these particles are situated at a distance r1, r2, r3 from the axis of rotation. Therefore we can write r1, r2, r3 from the axis of rotation n. Now this whole body is rotating with a angular velocity omega. Now the angular velocity of the whole body is same, therefore the angular velocity of each particle of mass m1, m2, m3, mn, the angular velocity remains same, but the linear velocity of each particle will be different. What is the reason? The reason behind this is that the distance of the particle from the axis of rotation in each case is different. Okay, now suppose the velocity of the first particle, linear velocity v1, that of second particle v2, third particle v3 up to n. Now this body is rotated with the angular velocity omega. Now we have to start this equation by considering the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity. In the 11th class we learned that linear velocity v is equal to r multiplied by angular velocity. Now for the first particle we can derive this relation as v1 is equal to r1 into omega. Now we are going to take here the formula of linear momentum. What is the linear momentum? Linear momentum denoted by letter p, and which is nothing but the mass of the particle multiplied by the velocity. Therefore for the first particle, the linear momentum of first particle p1 is equal to m1 multiplied by v1. Therefore we can write here this m1 and this v1 is r1 into omega. Therefore the linear momentum of the first particle is equal to m1 r1 omega. Now from this relation we derive the relation for our angular momentum. What is angular momentum? This angular momentum L is equal to P into R. Therefore, the angular momentum of the first particle similarly is L1 is equal to P1 multiplied by R1. Therefore, it is equal to M1 R1 square and into omega. This is equal to L1. Similarly, for the second particle, for the third particle, we can calculate the angular momentum of each particle. Therefore, we can write L2 is equal to M2 R2 square omega up to Ln, that is Mn Rn square into omega. Now, if we are to calculate the total angular momentum of the body, then we can add this angular momentum of each body. So we can write here that L is equal to L1 plus L2 plus Ln. Now we can write here M1 R1 square omega plus M2 R2 square omega plus m n r n square omega, which is equal to m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus m n r n square and common omega. Now this term can be written as summation of m I r I square, where this I vary from 1 to n and the common is omega. But we know the term in the bracket, this m I r I square summation, is nothing but the moment of inertia of the body. Therefore we can write here is I multiplied by omega. So this is the equation for angular momentum in the term of moment of inertia and its angular velocity. In this lecture we derive a relation for this angular momentum of the rotating body in the terms of moment of inertia. In the next lecture we are going to derive another relation for the torque acting on the body in the terms of moment of inertia. Here we are going to stop now. Thank you. Have a nice day.